How are you? Well, we finally made it into what we think are fall conditions. A month ago, we thought we were there, and what we found out that we had an extremely warm week just this past week. We had temperatures in the 90, historically low water. It moved the trout back into the mouths of the feeder streams again. And that is over, we think. So we're kind of happy that we can talk to you and say that fall appears like it's on the doorstep. We were in the 40s this morning, 43 degrees. The water's low, so the temperatures will drop very rapidly. And the long-range forecast is 40s and 50s at night, and occasional 30, in the 30s. So fall is here. The state is going to stock October 2nd. They always do a wonderful job on the stretch, putting in a really nice fish. They will distribute those fish as they normally do. And other good news, the club will stock. We are waiting for a little improved water conditions. I'd like to see a heavier flow rate. And then we will put fish in probably hopefully by mid-October. Everything at this point looks good. The upper half of the project has a lot of very big brown trout left in it. The lower half is a much slower fishing down through there, although they were getting trout in that cool weather right before the last heat wave, all the way to the far end of it. So things look good. The hatches are good, but the water's extremely low, so we need rain. Other good things that are happening, we have a new rod that we're introducing. I've been in this business for over 40 years. I'm 74 years old, started fly fishing at around 9 years old. And it's hard to get real excited over some new equipment. Although in the past we've had some wonderful, wonderful new offerings that we could do. The Sonic Wader, that was offered back a few years ago. It was just a wonderful improvement at a reasonably priced wader. It was super reliable and it was enjoyable selling it. Most of the time, anything that's supposed to be waterproof, you get very nervous when you're selling it. But the Sonic was wonderful. They have numerous improvements to the new one that will be coming out this spring. The other really neat thing is the H3 rods. And again, it's hard to get excited just because something is new, but if it's new and truly noticeably improved, that's noteworthy and should be talked about and considered, when you buy a new rod. And that might even give you a reason to buy a new rod. Again, they have reduced the wobble, the oscillation in it. Super accurate rod, cast extremely well. So we tested it out here on pine up the runs. So if you would like to come in and test cast one here in the yard, we have the 905s, which is an excellent rod for this area. We've got the 905 with lines on it, and you can go out, you can fish both the one built for distance and the other one for finer finesse casting. So come on up, give the rods a try and see what you think of them. Go out in the backyard, and if we have to, and if you need to make the final decision, you can fish it on the water a little bit and see what happens. Remember all of this, that the stocking and everything requires funds. So if you neglected to join for 2000 this year, seven, nor that, where are we, 16?
17.
17, all right. Join, come on in, and we would really appreciate your funds. We're looking forward to the final stocking in this October, and then we have to build the funds up to get ready for this coming March. So we hope by this March we will be legally allowed to offer some artwork raffles that we will have. So we used to have that's something that we want to use to make money other than just the regular membership. So things are looking good. Come up this fall, come on in and see us, and keep an eye out on the internet for conditions. Thank you.